chains about thy neck.
Cerrada tu cabeza y collares a tu cuello.
Turning over to 2 Timothy chapter number 3.
Volteando a 2 de Timoteo capítulo 3.
Verse 1 to 5. It says this, know also that in the last days perilous times shall come.
También debes saber esto, que en los postreros días vendrán tiempos peligrosos.
For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents. All of us, amen. Unthankful, unholy.
Porque habrán hombres amadores de sí mismo, avaros, vanagloriosos, soberbios, blasfemos, desobedientes a los padres, ingratos, impíos.
Without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good.
Sin afecto natural, implacables, calumniadores, intemperantes, crueles, aborrecedores de lo bueno.
Traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God.
Traidores, impuestos, enfatuados, amadores de los deleites más que de Dios.
Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away.
Que tendrán apariencia de piedad, pero negarán la eficacia de ella. Y a esto se evita.
Everyone say power.
Todos poder.
You are part of a powerful church.
Tú eres parte de una iglesia.
Can you put your
poderosa.
Bibles down and help me pray?
Si puedes poner
in the name of Jesus. We ask that you would anoint this time. Let this word be effective. And let us not just be hearers of the word, but let us be doers of the word. Anoint my lips to speak and your people's ears to hear. I pray that there would be miracles in this place, that there would be things that transpire in this place, that your promises will come to pass. Señor, haga tu voluntad. Señor, haga grandes cosas en este día. We believe it in the name of Jesus Christ. If you believe it, would you clap your hands? Hallelujah. With expectancy. Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated. I'm going to do my best to finish and get out of the way so God can do what he wants to do. I give honor to the Harding family and Sister Karen Harding. She's amazing. If you don't know this, she is famous. So get her autograph. We live in a day where churches are coming all over the place. It's cool to go to church. You mark off the checklist and you say, I went to church. But not every church is the same. There's some that have a form of godliness. Some that want to be comfortable in their church. And the Bible says that he is the head. He is the husband. And the church is the bride. So we better listen to mother. Because mom will keep us in line. Dad comes with the belt to spank us. But mom comes to comfort us. So I'm thankful to be part of a church. That's not like any other church. I'm thankful to have a mother. That's not like any other mother. But there's power in her presence. And there's power in this church. You could have gone to somewhere else today. But thank God you came to the powerful church. It's not because I'm here or because you're here. Because the Spirit of God is here. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And the Bible says you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost falls upon you. And guess what? What you feel here today is the Holy Ghost and power. And it's the Holy Ghost that can set you free. It's the Holy Ghost that will give you an edge in your life. To overcome disease. To overcome the valley. To overcome the death. And say, yet I will rise again. clap your hands right now. And you are already there in His presence. There's power. Power. Wonder working power. In the blood of Lamb. We are blood bought. Blood washed. Spirit filled. Powerful people. Because we're part of a powerful church. Hallelujah. We're not a club. We're not a social gathering. We're not people that just like to get together on Sundays. But every walk of life that's here today has come here for one purpose. To receive something from Jesus. And to let His power do what nothing else can do. Your money can't do it. Your career can't do it. Your relationships can't do it. But only Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, can do what nothing in this world can do. But we need the power. You need the power. What happens when we lose the power? You get used to living a lazy and apathetic life. And you feel like nothing excites you anymore. That's why you can come to United Pentecostal Church. And it doesn't matter what we're singing. It doesn't matter how you're feeling. We are in the presence of the Almighty King. And there's power endued from on high to set you free. And I believe that He wants to do that today. You ought to get proud about something. Some of you are proud about your mothers. You say, my mother makes the best cooking. No one makes her tamales like her. No one makes fried chicken like my mama. No one can touch her apple pie. And you get some proud feelings about your mother. That's why when you're born into the kingdom of God, you better believe you belong. Something that is alive. Something that has power. We're not outdated. We're not behind the times. We're not old fashioned. We just still live what the Bible teaches and preaches. And His word never changes. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. In Him, there's no shadow of turning. He doesn't change. So if He did it for them, He can do it for you. I want to know if you know someone that has a testimony and who would like to have that same type of testimony. Raise your hand. Do you believe that the promises of God can happen in your life? Then what are you waiting for? Why are you still sitting down? Why are you still sitting back? Why are you still in the place that Jesus wants to take you out of? It's because you belong to the powerful church that's going to set you free and give you the liberty you need. And let me tell you this, there's no separating God's power from His holiness. The Bible says, thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power in the beauties of holiness. You cannot separate them. That's why you can go to another church. But you won't feel what you feel here at Living Hope. Because there's the holy presence of God in this place. That's why you can look around. From the first prayer that was prayed to the song that was sung by Sister Hardy, tears flowing down the faces of people's faces. And they don't know why they're feeling what they're feeling. It's not anything else but the power of God. And you've got to realize that He has power. And we are part of the powerful church. He says that He has all the power. Job says He has the power. And Psalm, it says the prisoners will be released by the power of God. Paul says that God raised up the Lord and will also raise us up by His power. For He was crucified in weakness, but lives by the power of God. Devil, you thought you had me. World, you thought I was in trouble. Disease, you thought the diagnosis was going to define me. And I was doomed to die. But I've got the power. I've got the power of the Holy Ghost to get me through and set me free. And some have misused the power. And I'm here to remind you, you can't misuse the power. Because the power is what will set you free. And it's the only thing we need. And it's a promise from God. For He says, I will send a comforter. I will send the Spirit upon you. And you shall receive power. And they gathered together in an upper room. Just like this. And they waited. And they believed. And they received the power of God in that place. And in that place there were people that needed Jesus. They needed things to happen in their life. And the power was poured out upon them. You can't be born again without the Spirit and without the water. So if you've never received the Spirit with the evidence of speaking in a new tongue, this is your day to receive the power. If you've never been baptized in water in the name of Jesus, this is your day to be baptized. And I believe that Jesus wants to do a mighty work in this place. So when it comes to celebrating mothers, I think it's only fitting and right that we celebrate that we belong to the powerful church. You're not dead. You are alive. You're a part of the powerful church. I invite you to stand with me today. And I believe Jesus is going to do mighty works by His power. And in the name of Jesus, every thought will be put into captivity. And everything you have faced, and everything that you feel that is coming towards you, you have felt powerless. You have felt without. But I believe in the name of Jesus that today people are going to be set free. That your bodies will be made whole. That you'll go back to a home and you'll step into peace. That you'll go back to a family situation and it'll be mended. That you're going to go back for a checkup and the doctor says, we can't find it. When we celebrate the holiness of God. When we celebrate the power of God. And we let the Spirit pour out. Then Peter said unto them, repent. And be baptized, every one of you. In the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you.
Para vosotros,
and unto your children.
Es la promesa,
y para and to vos, all that are far off.
Para vuestros hijos y para todos los que están lejos.
Paul says.
Pablo dice,
in Romans 1 and 16.
Romanos 1, 16.
He says, for I am not ashamed.
Dice, no soy avergonzado.
Come on, say it with me. Say, I am not ashamed.
Porque no me avergüenzo.
Say it like you mean it.
Dilo porque no me avergüenzo.
Say it like you've got a problem. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also the Greek. Everyone say, that's me. The power belongs to you. Hallelujah. We are a powerful church. We are an attractive church. And we are known by our fruit.
Y somos conocidos por nuestro fruto.
And we are known by what we are.
Y somos conocidos por lo que somos.
We have the power.
Nosotros tenemos
through
el poder
Jesus
a través de
to be saved,
para poder ser salvos,
healed,
sanados,
and delivered.
Y liberados.
That's why they say, how did you get healed?
Por eso es que alguien dice, ¿cómo tú viste sanidad?
I go to the powerful church.
Oh, yo voy a la iglesia poderosa.
It's called Living Hope. By the power that resides in us. So if there's no power happening in your life, it's not anyone else's fault. It's just that you haven't tapped into the power. And I know it's Mother's Day. We got pot roast and reservations going on. And you wear your Sunday best for Mama. But I believe that today Jesus is going to fill those that need it with the gift of the Holy Ghost. And today Jesus is going to heal lives. So I want to ask you, I know you've been standing. Who here has never received the baptism of the Holy Ghost and you'd like to receive it today? Amen. I invite you to come forward. If you've never received it, just make your way forward. Hallelujah. We've got one already. We've got another one. Anyone else that never received the baptism of the Holy Ghost? Is there anyone else that has never received the baptism of the Holy Ghost? Is there anyone that's ever been water baptized in the name of Jesus? This is your day to be baptized. Just make your way forward. Now I want to know if there's someone here that's waiting for a promise to be fulfilled in your life. Would you raise your hand? And you have felt that you can't make it one more day. Come on, I need some honest folk here. I'm going to invite you to come forward. Because I believe Jesus is going to endue us with his power. In the name of Jesus. Now who here can just say, I just need the power of God in my life? Would you flood this altar? Come on. We're going to pray and believe. And we're going to know that Jesus is going to do something mighty in this place. Come on, make your way forward. Make your way forward. Hallelujah. Let's flood this altar. There's altar space to my right, to your left. I believe by under the sound of my voice, there's going to be evidence of miracles that take place. Now we're going to do something indecent and in order. Necesitamos orden en la casa de Dios. So just make your way forward.
Okay.
Before Jesus can do anything in your life,
antes que Jesús pueda hacer algo en tu vida,
the first miracle he did,
el primer milagro que él hizo,
was to fill the water pots.
Puede llenar
las ollas.
Las ollas.
He filled the water pots.
Él llenó los vasos, las vasijas.
He didn't take away the blindness.
Él no quitó la ceguera.
He didn't fix the hearing.
Él no arregló los oídos.
He didn't make you lose those extra pounds.
Él no te hizo perder esas extras libras.
He didn't raise the dead.
Él no levantó los muertos.
He filled the water pots.
Sino que él llenó las vasijas.
So today the greatest miracle Jesus is going to do for all of us
entonces,
here today
el milagro más grande
is to fill this vessel with the living water of Jesus. And so we're going to pray this prayer together. Would you raise your hands with me? Would you pray with me? Hallelujah. Yes. And we're going to pray this prayer of repentance in the name of Jesus. Forgive me of every sin. Forgive me of every evil thought. Every evil deed. Every evil work. Lord, forgive me right now. And I repent of my sins. Come on, you got to talk to him. Say, Lord, cleanse me. Purify
me.
And in the name of Jesus, I pray that your spirit would fall in this place here today. Because we're part of the powerful church. And we're going to count to three. And at three, we're going to lift up our voice. And we're going to shout hallelujah. As soon as you feel your tongue and lips begin to move, it's a new language. Just let it out. And I know without a shadow of a doubt that Jesus is going to heal and restore and fill. Are you ready?